In this video, I'm going to talk to you about adding overlays to a scene within Ecamm Live and explain some of the use cases for them. Now, overlays are graphical elements that you can add to a scene, and these can be in the form of text, a screen share, videos, and more importantly, a camera to show off your beautiful self to your audience. So let's take a look at how you can add overlays to a scene within Ecamm Live. All right, so now let's talk about overlays and the different overlays that you can add to a particular scene. So let's get back into Ecamm Live. You can see here that we have our main scene, but let's create a couple of scenes with a couple of different types of overlays to give you a flavor of what you can add within Ecamm Live's scenes. So let's create a new scene. Click on the plus button down here, and we're going to call this Website. So there are a couple of ways that you can share a website within Ecamm. You can go down the traditional method of creating a screen share, which will be sharing Chrome, Safari, whatever browser that you have running. Or you can use something called a web widget, which is a functioning browser within Ecamm that you can just add a simple URL and that will display the website of your choice. And for the purposes of this demo, I'm going to create a web widget for the Ecamm site and put it into our scene. So we've just created our blank scene called a website. Now I'm going to add a camera overlay. So go back down to the overlays menu and we're going to add camera by hitting the plus button on the camera. You can see it just remembers the last camera that we had set before, and I'm going to change this camera's look and feel because we want to add that as an overlay in addition to our web widget. So if you click on the little pen tool, I'm going to change the shape of this camera overlay from a widescreen 16:9, and I'm going to change it to a circle. Click on circle, and there you have a circle. I'll just grab the edges of this circle and make it smaller. Nobody wants to be that big when you're sharing a website. I'm just going to put myself down here on the bottom left-hand side. And then I'm going to go back over to the overlays menu and select this little globe, which is the web widget overlay. Click on this and you'll get a couple of parameters come up. Let's give it the name Ecamm site. Like that, we put in our URL, and this is one I put in earlier, so it's just ecamm.com. And I'll just leave everything else as default for now. The width and height is a personal preference. You can resize it anyway. You can keep this running in the background, which means that when you switch between scenes, the website will keep running. I'll check that for now, and you can fill the entire frame if you want. But I'm just going to leave the rest as default and add this as a widget overlay. And bingo, you can see straight away that the Ecamm website comes up within the browser. And you can move this and resize it around accordingly. So I'm going to put it here, not make it full screen. Click and drag it across. As you can see, it snaps into place. Make it just in the center. And you can see the blue guidelines within Ecamm that allow you to show you where it is positioned with respect to your scene, and that slap bang in the center. But you'll notice that I'm behind the website. Not a bad thing, I hear you cry, but I'm going to move myself to the top of the website. And the overlays work in a layers workflow, whereby anything that's below a particular layer is shown behind it. And if you have something on top of your camera, then that's going to be in front of you. So I'm just going to simply click and drag the Ecamm site overlay down behind the camera. Now the camera is on top and the website is behind. Now you'll notice down at the bottom, there are a couple of controls within this web widget. The first one is this little hand control, which means if it's over to the left, I can resize and place the web widget where I want within my scene, which we've just done. And if I click it to the right, it now means that I can treat this as a browser and I can scroll through this website as I would do normally. So this is, remember, a web widget running within Ecamm, within your scene, and you can click on any of the links as you would do a normal browser, and it will take you to the respective pages. If you want to go back a page, you've got the left and right buttons here, similar to a browser. So you click on the one on the left and that will take you back. Click on the one forward, that's going to take you forward. And then refresh is simple as that. It's going to refresh the screen just like you would do in a normal browser. So that's a web widget. Super easy, very convenient, and an easy way of getting a website into a scene within your live production. Next up, we'll go and look at how to share a screen, portion of your screen, either a presentation or something else, using the screen share overlay. There are a number of amazing resources available to help you get started with Ecamm Live, enabling you to stream like a boss. And I've listed a number of the key resources here to help you with your Ecamm journey. And I'd encourage you to join the Discord or the Facebook group, as there are a bunch of knowledgeable people waiting to help and support you on these platforms. Take it easy, happy streaming, and welcome to the Ecamm fam.